Apollo 11 first landed on the moon. And I have with me, what you're looking at here, is RoboKnot. So to explain that, the deputy director of NASA Johnson Space Center, Vanessa. Vanessa, you have a huge job. You're over the astronauts, mission control, everything. So first off, tell us what we're looking at, though.
Oh, great. So you're looking at a part of our Moon to Mars exhibit. And what we're focusing on right now is the Moon to Mars mission, and it's called Artemis. So Apollo, which we're celebrating the 50th anniversary of the landing, we are now thinking about how we're going to go forward to the moon again. And so the mission is called Artemis. And with Artemis, we'll have the first woman and the next man to go to the moon.
Okay.
And that's going to happen in 2024. So in this area, we're focusing on our moon. We have our moon globe here. We also have on the other side the Orion port vehicle, which is going to be used for testing of astronauts being recovered from space. And what we're walking past right now is a display that will then focus on what are we going to be doing currently on board the space station. So what he's looking at is the spacesuit that's used on board the space station when we go outside to do spacewalks.
Wow.
And we're going to tell people all about what it takes to live in space. And students can come out and they'll do some interactive experiments. They will be able to launch some rockets. They will have virtual reality goggles, and they can actually virtually explore the space station. We're also very excited about new rockets that we're going to be launching. SpaceX and Boeing are going to be developing new vehicles that will be launching soon, and that will carry our astronauts back to the space station.
Wow.
Currently, we're launching from Russia, so it will be great for us to be launching again from Florida.
That's amazing.
Yes.
Well, that's all happening today. Citco's Freedom Over Texas happening tonight, and you can still get tickets. It's $10 at the gate, and you can do this with the Space City Experience, and there's so much more out here, so be sure to go out here and celebrate the 4th of July coming up at the 9 a.m. hour. We're going to show you some more of this experience that you can have. For now, reporting live at the Space City Experience, I think I've said that like four times, 30 seconds, Rashi Batz, Fox 26 News.